Dr. Suzanne Levine is a podiatrist here in New York. She joins us this morning to tell us which ones will save your souls. Good morning.
Good morning.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
So Band-Aids are sort of like the old favorite, right, to help you sort of alleviate the pain.
No question about it. Mm-hmm. I had this in my bag the other day. Someone was limping in the street, and I actually gave them one.
Really?
And this time of year, we're so prone to blisters. Ugh. So it's good to just carry them around.
Just in case.
Just in case.
All right. Well, there's a lot of new products that are out on the market now. I mean, there's something for, I think, every problem that you could possibly have, right?
No question about it.
So what do we have up first?
Well, the first product is yoga toes. And, you know, it's an interesting. Originally, when I got it, I said, oh, this must be nonsense. But it isn't. It really makes your feet feel comfortable, those 38 little muscles that you mm-hmm. put into your shoes all day.
Okay.
And it relaxes your feet. And it's kind of stress reduction at the end of the day. I'm not so sure about it correcting all the problems, but it does feel good.
It feels good. Yeah. Now, our producers gave me some yesterday to try.
Okay.
They swear by it. I mean, we have a lot of women in the office who love them. I found them a little uncomfortable, but I think that's the point, right? They're supposed to
yes.
first stretch your toes
yes.
way
you know,
out.
You know what it feels like? It feels the equivalent of putting your fingers in between your toes and actually
right.
stretching the muscles.
Okay.
So it feels good.
Okay. Now, bunions. Bunions, I hear, are incredibly painful.
They're so painful. And when you have one and you put on these tight shoes and your
yeah.
feet swell in the summertime mm-hmm. with the high humidity, it could be really uncomfortable. We have here some bunion pads. It's worth a try. Many of them take up too much room in the shoe.
Okay.
So you have to really be careful.
And do you recommend surgery?
Well, if it gets real painful, we do it. I mean, usually it's done on a Friday, and a lot of people go back to work Monday or Tuesday wearing those huge surgical shoes.
Right, so if the problem is that severe.
I would try some conservative therapy first.
Okay. Right. Let's talk about the heel products. Heel spurs.
Oh, God, that could be so painful. You put your foot down in the morning, and all of a sudden you have pain at the back of the heel.
Wow.
And usually it's good to change your heel height, but there's some great products here. You have the heel liners.
Mm-hmm.
You have the heel cushions.
Mm-hmm.
You can try some of these heel pads. And most important is to actually avoid flat shoes.
Really?
If you have heel pain, the worst thing you can do is put flat shoes on. So try to lift up the heel of your shoe.
A little bit, at least.
Yes.
Okay, that's a good tip. These are a little more expensive, $49.99, and they're not found in the drugstores like these other lower-priced products. They're called foot pedals. What's that?
Okay, well, I thought this was kind of cutesy, something you can throw in your bag if you're hiking or if you're away for the weekend. It has the heel cushioning, it has the heel grips, and it has a few other things that actually can help your feet if your feet are starting to hurt.
So it's a whole little feet-in-a-bag kind of thing.
Right.
Everything you could possibly need?
Everything you can need, especially for stilettos.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
We have to wear our stilettos, Dr. Levine. All right. Ball of foot cushions.
Okay. Well, you know, as we age, the only part of the body we lose cushioning is under the ball of the foot. You know, the burning you get.
Yeah.
So it's certainly worth a try to use some of these devices. You have Dr. Jill's, you have Dr. Scholl's, all of these cushioning devices to actually replace what nature's taken away.
Mm-hmm.
So it's worth a try.
All right.
And if all else fails, you know, sometimes you have to have different procedures done.
All right. The last thing, a few seconds left. Blister spray. You say this is great stuff.
Great stuff. And it's new on the market. Certainly when you start getting that irritation from your shoes,
mm-hmm.
your feet are starting to swell.
Okay.
It's the end of the day. You have no socks on and you're starting to get blisters.
That's the worst.
This is definitely something great to use. And they're new products. Unlike the Band-Aid, they last longer and they feel comfortable.
Okay. About $6 or $7. Not at all. Something that we don't have here that I personally swear by is Moleskine.
Well, we use it in our office
all
the time.
And it's sort of like a felt with an adhesive, and it's good for the blisters and the corns and whatever's rubbing. And
absolutely, and you can cut it to fit any area.
Yeah, so there are a lot of things.
There's some really great products, and some of these are really terrific.
Good
stuff. So most important is to take care and pamper your feet.
That's right. We can all benefit from some of this stuff. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you for
Suzanne
having
Levine.
Me.
Thank you for being here this morning. Rob, I know you don't have any of these problems, but, you know, the women, we wear the stilettos. We need this stuff.
Darlene is so gelling.
Yes, she's gelling.
Isn't she?
She's swelling.
So much better
not
than
yet.
Swelling.
I'm not swelling yet.
No, I mean, you're swell.
Not just yet,
swell.
You know. But thanks for looking out.
She's talking moleskin. I just got old skin.